And Bible hope, people, is not the way we use the in our English vernacular, we use the word hope. Hope means maybe it happened, maybe it might not happen. But Bible hope is certainty of good happening in your future. Hope is a certainty in the Bible. Bible hope is certain of good. When you wake up in the morning, especially, the devil will shoot the first thought with negative thoughts about the day, about your body, about your family, about your job. Straight away, put on the helmet of hope and say, it's going to be a great day because I'm a branch of the living vine. There's nothing that I'll face today that the supply will not be there from the vine. I may not know what to do initially, but I'll stop and remember I'm just a branch. I'm not the supplier. I am the supplier. Amen. I refuse to worry. There is no care. There is no concern. All the care is Christ. Amen. Straight away put that thought in your mind. And the word, you know what? Israel today, the nation of Israel, our national anthem is Majula. Das is Hatikva. Ha means the. Tikva is the noun for Kava. It means the hope. The hope. It's a beautiful music. It's really na 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 na. Very haunting. It's called Hatikva, which means the hope. It's the noun for this verb Kava. When the spies stole Rahab of Jericho, the prostitute, when we come into your city, remember to put out a rope of scarlet thread. The word rope is the word tikva. Stretch out your hope. Your hope is in the blood of Jesus, the red blood of Jesus. Because of his blood shed, you can be expecting good things in your future. You know, this week is going to be great. Okay? And the Lord showed me this. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And the Lord said to me, son, the world has it opposite. First of all, here it says you shall mount up first. That means you will soar with wings like eagles. In fact, the Bible says God renews your youth like the eagles. And the eagle's renewal of its youth is the molting process. It's literal. So we will mount up with wings like eagles. First of all, when you wait on the Lord, spend time in that word. Either late at night or early in the morning, find time to spend time with the living vine. Stay close. Stay in touch with Jesus. And then you will soar. You will soar first. Second, you will run and not be weary. Third, you will walk and not faint. And the Lord said this to me, and I wrote it in my notebook. The Lord said this to me, the world has it upside down. The world always walk first. And then they run. But they never saw. God says, you start, your strength will be like this. You start with me in the heavenlies. You soar with wings like eagles first. And then you will run and not be weary. You will walk and not faint. Can I have a good amen, church? Do we have that in the Bible? God who cannot lie, the thrice holy God who cannot lie, tells us we will run and not be weary. He will renew our youth like the eagles. There is a man in the Bible, and I close with this, a man who has forgotten to grow old. His name is Caleb, and we'll close with this. Caleb was with Joshua, remember, when they came out of the spying out the land for 40 days, he was one of them who said, let us go up at once. We are well able to take the land. Their defense has departed from the giants. They are bread for us. They saw their difficulties as food. Every day, if there's difficulty, it's food for me because I'm connected to the living vine. There is no situation that I'll be faced with that the Lord will not have a supply or an answer for. And even if I don't have an answer for it, I can rest in the living vine knowing that He's taking care of it. I don't have to worry about it. The devil will come to you and say, what are you going to do about it? You say, me? Moi? Not me. Go check with Jesus. If you don't do it, it will fall. If fall, fall. You must have this attitude. And I keep on reminding myself because it's a battle. I was sharing with Pastor Darren just the other day that I even forgot my message for a while on live the let go life. I preached a message years ago called live the let go life. The more you let go, God holds. You hold, God let go. Go ahead. You let go, God holds. You hold, God let go. Which one do you want? You want me to hold or you hold? Let me tell you, his hand is bigger. His hand is more powerful. He is more loving. He sees the end from the beginning. And he knows the way ahead. Let go. All right? With all your... You cannot... Anyway, back to this story of Caleb. When he went into the promised land, he was 40 years old. And 45 years after he went into the land as a spy, he is now in the promised land. And he came to Joshua and he said this, Joshua, remember how the Lord preserved us? Watch, let's see his own words. Now behold, he's talking to Joshua, Caleb. The Lord has kept me alive. Who has kept him alive? The Lord. So even, why worry? Who will keep you alive? The Lord. You know, when you switch on the radio, be careful when you switch on the radio. All right, instead of listening to Pastor Prince, you listen to radio. Okay. Sometimes you will hear an expert saying, one out of five Singaporeans will suffer this. Switch it off. Because the more you create that expectancy, for a moment you forget that you are not of the world. If that lady acted the testimony I shared just now, like she is of the world, she will never be where she is. With the harvest that she had, the fruits, the abundant fruit of health that she had. We are in the world, but we are not of the world. The world is part of the thousand that fall, will not fall. So watch it when people have health bites and health this and health that in the magazine periodicals, and many a times the health portions are actually sickness consciousness portion. You can run every day and be fit, but fit is not health. Health comes from the Lord. Strength comes from the Lord. You can be fit and not be healthy. Meditate on that. Anyway, I'll close with this time. Behold, the Lord has kept me alive, as he said, this 45 years. Ever since the Lord spoke this word to Moses while Israel wandered in the wilderness. And now, here I am this day, 85 years old. As yet, he told Joshua, I am as strong this day as on the day that Moses sent me. How old was he then? 40 years old. And this old man forgot to grow old because he didn't read the magazines that we read. He does not watch the programs that we watch. He does not listen to the radio that we listen to. He's only conscious of the Lord and what the Lord said. And he says, the Lord kept me alive and I'm as strong this day. And by the way, these people don't lie, okay? These are people under the law. They're under the law at that time. Amen? I mean, it's a sin for them to bear false witness. And he's saying to Joshua, and Joshua can tell whether he is or not. He said, I'm as strong this day as on the day that Moses sent me. Just as my strength was then, so now is my strength for war and for going out and coming in. Now, this is him. I mean, he's not saying it's a spiritual strength, Joshua. It's not like, Joshua, I'm strong today, but you can't see it, but it's a spiritual strength. All right? He's saying, I'm strong this day for war. He can take anyone on. I mean, it's a literal renewal. Just like, this is not playing games with words. Just like Sarah at 90 years old, God, the Bible says she was past the age of childbearing, but she counted God faithful. She didn't count herself faithful. She counted God faithful. Even when you don't have faith, he is faithful. It is not you holding on to him. See that he is holding on to you. If you hold on to him, you might let go. He holds on to you. Never. So when your faith runs out, rest on the faithful one. If we abide faithless, he abides faithful. So he says, I'm strong these days on the name Moses sent me, just as my strength was then, so now is my strength for war, for going out and for coming in. Look at the next verse. Now therefore, give me this mountain. At 85 years old, there was a mountain, and you know who was at the mountain? The Anakims. These were the giants. The same giants that was in the promised land, in Jericho, the Anakims, We're also at Hebron, the mountain of Hebron. It is still there, by the way, the mountain there. In fact, some of the pastors visited there last month in Hebron, the mountain of Hebron. And he says, give me this mountain. For you heard in that day how the Anakim, the giants, were there, and the cities are great and fortified. It may be the Lord will be with me, and I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said. And watch what happened. Joshua blessed him and gave Hebron to Caleb. That means he went in, conquered the giants, and left, cast them out. And the mountain became his. The world will say, you are over the hill. God's people say, no, give me the hill. Give me the mountain. Amen. I tell you this, you will surprise yourself when you live the vine life. There'll be people 10 years younger than you, and you are stronger than them. And they are perpetually fatigued and tired. Even the youth will utterly fall, but you are kept strong. That is, you don't accept the lies of the devil. And the moment you start forgetting things, don't say, I'm getting old. And don't accept when doctors tell you it's part of the aging process in your heart. I reject that in Jesus' name. Amen. Even young people forget, or else all of them will excel in their exams. If only that gift is given to our children. But people, you are different. You are connected to the living vine. When I look at the world, it's all dead branches. All dead branches. Withered branches. When I look at you, living branch. And the devil hates it, because you are a living testimony. You are bearing fruit, more fruit, much fruit, and the devil hates it. So you bring accusation. See, feel that pain? See that symptom? You see, you're getting old. You feel the aches? You feel the pains? That's what happens when you become 40 years old. You see? Notice that? You heard what the radio said just now? All right? That's very normal for you to feel this way. You feel the hot flushes? Yeah, menopause. You see that? All I know is that we are sons and daughters of Abraham. And you are daughters of Sarah. And the Bible says you are a daughter of Sarah if you are not given to fears and hysterical, you know, fears and worries. And it says that you are daughters of Sarah. And I asked the Lord one time in that verse, I said, Lord, why do you say daughters of Sarah? Why do you say daughter of Sarah and not daughters of Esther or Ruth? They are wonderful ladies. And God said to me, because Sarah was the only woman in the Bible who had her youth renewed and her menopause reversed. Amen. And I'll tell you this, just look out. You get pregnant, don't blame me. If you keep on listening to the word, let me just tell you this, you keep on listening to this word, you keep on washing, you never know what's gonna happen, you know. You bear fruit, more fruit, much fruit. All right, please don't come after me, okay? Praise God. Give Jesus the praise. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, you are the branches of the living vine. Amen, friend. It all begins with being connected to the living vine. This vine, once upon a time, was alone. All alone. But God sent him. Jesus Christ, the Son of God. 100% man. 100% God. God man. As man, he came to die. Yes, friend. He came to die. He was the only baby born to die. God sent him in a body, in the likeness of sinful flesh. Not in sinful flesh, but in the likeness of sinful flesh, like you and I, so that he would die. And why? Because all of us have sinned against God. All of us have turned every man to his own way. We're like sheep gone astray. We didn't care about God that loves us. We didn't care about God of faithfulness, a God who cannot lie, a God who has our best interest at heart. We're like sheep gone astray. And God cared for us. Even when we didn't care for him, he loved us before we knew him. It was while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Christ bore your sins and he gave you his righteousness. He was cursed that you might be blessed. He was forsaken so that God will always be with you You have God's constant presence. He will never leave you nor forsake you. If that is you, wherever you are, and you want to be connected to the living vine, pray this prayer right now with me. If you're watching this by way of television, if you want this to become real in your life, say this after me from your heart. Say,